The economies of most developed nations of Europe and Asia are anchored on the contributions of small and medium-scale enterprises. Today, our vision for Ondo-State is to ensure that SMEs account for 60% of the GDP of Ondo-State by 2022 through the introduction of entrepreneurship training, managerial skills training for small business owners and artisans, establishment of business incubation centers where new businesses can pool resources together, exchange ideas, share common amenities and reduce costs so as to increase the business survival and sustainability rate in the state. Some of the youths have this to say during a conversation with youths and students in Akumba, Akoko.
Thank you very much. My name is Adebola Odunyemi. You can see the bastard, the student union president of Adekunle Ajayi University, Akumba, Akoko, Ondo State. Sincerely speaking, I'm seeing Ade Ogun for the very first time. I'm listening to him speaking for the very first time. I must confess, I'm amazed. This is an eye-opener. It is revealing and it intriguing. You know, I have not had such charging in recent years. You know, I was charged. I was speaking. I don't just know how to express that because he has told us to go and draw out our 10 years development plan. You can imagine at 49, he said he had the house in the UK, he has one in the Canada. My brother, what can be more intriguing than that? As a youth, he has achieved a lot. He's charging me up as I'm here, I don't know. Been here studying law at 25, he told me he graduated at 22. I'm above 25, I'm still studying law, you know. If I have the opportunity to go and charge others up, I will do that with utmost sincerity by charging the younger ones up to when they need to seek admission on time and to be on the street hustling to get money.
It's a bold step. It's a one in a million. It's wow. It's awesome. If we can have 10 of these coming down to this state, basically Akoko and let's say probably some of the local government too, Ondo State would have gone beyond this normality.
Well, the man is saying that we should fight and be ready to learn and be hardworking in order to have a greater future in life.
Like what he just did there, he came back to his town to empower youth. If we have leaders like him, they can come back here to empower youth that we have nowadays. It says something there. It said, you don't have to give everybody money in order to get where you want to. You have to start on your own. You don't have to relent on people. You have to take up your hustle. Like, youth, you understand the word hustling. You have to hustle in order to get where you are.
Hey, I can't lie to you. When I got here this afternoon, I was really inspired by what this man actually said today. If all our leaders in this country can ever be like this man, oh my God, this country wouldn't be the same the way it is anymore. I see him as a man that really believes so much in the youth. Not even in what, you know, the youth want to offer tomorrow, but what the youth want to do today. You know, you got what I mean like there. He believes so much that, you know, this country would be a better place if only we can change the orientation of the youths, the minds of the youths. How to really make this country a better place for, you know, individuals. He has worked, he has made money on his own, been to so many countries, not even demanding, even requesting any money from anyone. But he's not ready to pay people, to give back to people what he has actually worked for. So I believe he's a very good man, and if all, you know, all governors, and even the head of you know, the country, I mean the president, can actually emulate him, I believe this country will be a better place for you and I.
I must confess, the problem we have in Nigeria is we don't have leaders who have the interest of the masses at heart. This is exactly what a sound mind should be doing. A sane leader. This is exactly what they should be doing. There should be a constant reorientation of the youth. so as for them not to go astray, so as for them to embrace, you know, peace. In this, there's no how you leave your, you deject the youth and expect good things to come out of them. Now, if something of this nature can be coming up intermittently, I can assure you, nobody will be on the street parading himself as street beggars or as miscreants or hoodlums or street urchins as it may be. Nobody on this planet that will go outside there and say he wants to start kidnapping anybody, because your intelligent question has been widely opened, your horizon has been broadened, then you have to go outside there and think of what you can do to better the lot of people outside there. Sincerely speaking, that's why I said I don't know how best to describe him. He's the best.
First, I must commend the initiators. I'm talking about the initiators of the Brentwood Trinity Youth Leadership Initiative. This is a very welcome initiative at this very crucial moment where it's more like our youth are really missing it. Because at this point, this is more like a wake-up call to the youth on why we have to stand up for ourselves and start to see ourselves beyond leaders of tomorrow, but start seeing ourselves as leaders of today.
So I think if we're having programs like this once in a while, it's going to be to the youth advantage. It's going to waking them up from their sleep. Because most people, until you tap them before they know, okay, this is the right thing to do, they just believe they should be there. Nobody to encourage them. Nobody to like give them what they want to hear. But with this now, we believe youths will be able to come up new ideas and to like, okay, it's time for me to take a step to do something instead of just sitting down at home doing nothing. So I think it's a welcome development.
I would like to say something. You see, in Akoko, we are divided. Because of the languages we are speaking, maybe the difference in language, I don't know. But what I discover is that everybody does things as his own suit. He sees the problem in Akoko as the people, some of the people that needed to be concerned in some of the problem facing Akoko. They were there doing nothing, and they don't see it as the bone of the contention. So if to say most of our leaders in Akoko are concerned about the development of Akoko, I don't think Akoko should be in deteriorated condition. Look at the infrastructure, everything. It's not just fast going.
I'll find it difficult to forgive myself if I fail to attend this kind of program, and at the same time appreciate the organizer, because I have always said to my colleagues that one of the major solution to the problem of the country is reorientation. When you reorientate people towards what they need to do, of course people are still living in the past mentality, the African orientation, African concept of living. There, people have not been rebranded to what is expected and the standard of living.
At first, when I was invited for this program, I just felt it's one of those things. Let me just go and see what's happening. But coming here and hearing the convener speak for the first 3 minutes, it really triggered something in me and has woken me up to reality that, Rita, your tomorrow starts from today. You don't have to wait till tomorrow to get something doing. Well, we may say the country is in recession, the country is bad, but I think we can actually, out of nothing, we can actually make something out of it. That is, if we are really determined to do so.
You know, youth at 20, there was a popular saying that says, if you are not handsome at 20, you are not strong at 30. At 40, you are not wise, and 50, you are not rich. Then you should forget your existence. As a matter of fact, he has all these qualities. At 20, I believe he's handsome. At 30, he was strong. At 40, he was wise. And now, close to 50, he had already made it. So the man is just too scintillating and simply the best child I've had over time. Sincerely speaking, he has opened my eyes to the realities of life, how to be a responsible man in the nearest future, how to not to follow political jobbers, propagating nonsense or by causing political episodes on the social media. You know, the effect of the social media, he has been able to itemize it. Sincerely speaking, I don't know how best to describe him. But he has done me good today by at least charging me up. And you can be rest assured, at the end of this lecture, I can't just wait to put my plans into actions and see what comes out of it in the next 10 years. Possibly within the next 10 years, I should be able to have my own house in the UK, one in Canada, and at the end of the day, dine with kings and, you know, call governors to come and meet me in my own house as well.
So. I just wish this program can go beyond this level and make youth of Nigeria realize that if we keep on moving towards the same trend all the time, we'll keep falling. And our leaders, so to say, will keep using us as maybe political, whatever, I don't want to know. But we have to wake up to things that are real. You have to create things for yourself. You have to wake up to know that you have to, I don't really know the better word to use for it, but I think this initiative is wow. And as you can see, oftentimes you see some people coming together to organize something. This one will gather a group, another one will gather another group. But I think out of all the ones I've been attending, kudos to this initiative.
I like the fact that he came here to empower us and the likes of other leaders. We don't have to be a governor for you to come here.
The foundation for that tomorrow starts from now. So I must really commend the initiators of this, and I think it really go a long way to really put us in the right path of leadership and give us the kind of hope that will give us a new generation of leader that will actually lead us to the promised land.
We have people like this who is willing and ready to help people, to wake them from their sleep. It's time for you to take steps, because the world we live in today is a political world, in short. And these people, they've seen us as people that are to be used. Once you use them, you leave them after that. But if we have leaders like this, okay, come, let me teach you how to fish, rather than just give you stipend to spend, which will eventually get exhausted in a short period of time. I think it's a good development, and if our government can go into this also, encourage people that are into this, so that we'll have more people. Because I understand something, mostly if you are not outside your own area, you won't know there are some people out there who are ready to help, who are willing to help. But if the government can encourage this, rather than doing the opposite, I think more people will come, like help people.
I'm very, very happy and glad to be a partisan of this program. If our politicians in Ondo State have been doing these things for us for a long time, like our senators, Senator Ajayi Boniface, if he has tried his possible best to empower the youth in Ondo State, even in Ondo North Central District, I think today, majority of us will have been in a better place. Not a tall green, not another persons. And if some of us are graduates, and some of us cannot do a white collar job, and we think our people that have that money, they should even encourage us to go and learn some works, like tailor, like Almaco products, like ties, tie detailers, and other things, so that we can be able to control our family, we can be able to gather our own family, to have a wife, to have a children at home, to continue to do a normal things in outside, not a political talk.
Let me be very frank with you. It is a common knowledge that we all understand now that the white collar job is not just there anymore. And that is why there is need for us to start looking for maybe the green or the blue collar job and put our side beyond the civil service job, that we believe we must all go into the civil service or find ourselves in a kind of luxury hobby. So I must commend that this is a very welcome initiative. And truly, if we are going to take ourselves outside the shackle of unemployment and poverty in this country, then we have to start looking towards the direction of self-employment. And I think the initiator, Adi Adeogun, the Brentwood in Trinity initiative, I think they're doing a very good job and it's a very welcome one.
Since January till now, this empowerment program that I could say that that has happened in Akoko, and it's good it has come at this time, because many people in Akoko, they are into farming. I mean, because most of people don't even have money to train their children in school, and the people that can encourage them, giving them that belief that they can still make it, they were not there. We need this. People like this that can encourage people that you can still make it in life. Our people are living in the world of ideology. The ideologies are killing the instincts of most of our youth, most of our people that are supposed to be helping others. we have to be dwelling in the world of realist. A realist sees everything possible.
Of course, it's a fact that the government doesn't have any job they are giving anybody as well, because if they start employing everybody in this country, then it means, you know, the government will only have their money to pay everyone. But the moment we have the idea that we can get something to do on our own, we can be self-employed, that we can be employer of labors, then we start the change ourselves. We continue to change the society, change the system ourselves there. So it's a very good initiative, and of course, you know, that's just basically what we need as at this time there. So it's directly giving out what we need to the people there. And once again, I would like to commend and acknowledge and appreciate him on behalf of the entire Ondo State students, that we believe his initiative will change this generation, and something we expect more of some of our leaders who call themselves leaders there to come and contribute back and give back to the society.
There is no white collar job anywhere again in Nigeria now. I'm telling us, if we don't go back to business, we are missing it. The job is not just there. It's not just there. If you said you will go to school because of the result and you were looking for one job, my brother, you have missed it. You have to look for something you can do, something you have passion for, something you need that can earn you a good living, that can even have remain and train others. It's not there. I was opportunity to travel to Abuja of recent. I went to some of the parasitas, you know, to meet some of my people, my relative. I saw that it's not that. I saw many vacant positions. It's not that they don't want to employ, but the money is not there to pay the salary. Even look at the state we are. The allocation they are receiving before has reduced drastically. There is no way they can employ. In that, they have to maximize what they have to make sure they give out a good output to the entire public. And in this aspect, they are telling us that if we have not been self-reliant before, we should go and make sure that we are self-reliant in taking the bull by the horn.
We appreciate Adi Adeogun for bringing this program. We are still expecting more of this program from Adi Adeogun, so that our youth will have an orientation that the thuggery and some other social vices like cultism is not good for us to do, particularly in Akoko Land.
We need to think of coming to the society to give back to us. We need to think of organizing this program and not giving us 1,000 naira to go and be destroying somebody's property or to go and be fighting one political enemies. This is the best any leader can do to the youth. This is the best way at brushing up the youth so that they will not go out of their band. This is the best way to prevent militants and Niger Delta Avengers from destroying our pipeline. This is the best way at ending corruption in our country. If this can be coming up intermittently, like I told you earlier on, Ondo State is going to be the best place to be. It's going to be a safe haven for all and sundry. And to this Adeogun that I'm seeing for the very first time, I doff my cap for him, because he's simply the best. And he has actually made me a better person, because I'm thinking of how I can go outside there and impact others now, because he has impacted me. So this is exactly what those who occupy the National Assembly, those who occupy positions of authority, will be doing. Come up with teachers, charge the youth up. That is when we can aspire bigger like them. But the unfortunate in this part of the world is nobody wants the younger ones to be bigger than them. But as for him now, he always wants all of us to progress. That is the reason why he has come up with this idea. You can rest assured in the next 2-3 years, most of us there will be the best in this country and will be the one piloting the affairs of the state.
With the support of the youths, the light of prosperity will shine once more on the people of Ondo State.